The very important topic in this basic mathematics is differentiation. And we are going to define many physical quantities with the help of this differentiation only. See, where we are going to use? In kinematics, suppose if you see, this is some y-axis, x-axis, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Initially, the object is at plus 1 meter at 10 o'clock, 30 minutes. It is at plus 1. Now it is moving towards a positive x-axis. It came to plus 2, plus 3, and plus 4. Now the time is 10 hours 31 minute. That means to move from plus 1 to plus 4, it takes 1 minute. Suppose if we take this as x1, this as x2, so the displacement of the object is x2 minus x1, and that is equal to 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3, and time t equal to some 1 minute. So what is average velocity? Average velocity equal to, you know, displacement by time duration, that is x2 minus x1. Let me take this as t1, this as t2. So t will be equal to t2 minus t1. So t2 minus t1, I can write it as delta x by delta t, means small displacement by small time duration taken. So this we call it as change of x with respect to time. So change of x with respect to time, if we study, indirectly we are studying about average velocity. In the same way, instantaneous velocity is equal to change of x with respect to time at a particular instant, dx by dt. So here, this instantaneous velocity we have defined with the help of differentiation. Also, we call it as rate of change of displacement at a particular instant, or differentiation of x with respect to time. Differentiation of x with respect to time. That means with the help of this differentiation knowledge, we are going to define some physical quantities. And average acceleration is equal to delta v by delta t. Instantaneous acceleration, that is equal to dv by dt. Average force, that is equal to delta p by delta t. Instantaneous force, that is equal to dp by dt. So many times we are going to get the differentiation terms. To deal with those type of formulas or concepts, we must need the knowledge of this differentiation. So first I will go for mathematical approach as far as this differentiation is concerned, and later I will give you examples where we are going to use that differentiation in physics, and how to solve those problems by using, how to solve the problems in physics